video. Today we're going to learn how to create an access point using what we call using two modems, two Huawei modems. They're gonna be identical. This time we wanna be different from other people what they do. This is gonna be a wireless modem. Some people they use ADSL modems, but this time we're using wireless modem to be an access point. So now what you're gonna do? What you do, we have Huawei, it's gonna be these modems, oh, both of these modems are, let me show you, they are Huawei B315, okay, and also Huawei B315, okay. Modem 1 is gonna sit in building 1, okay. Modem 2 is gonna sit in building 2 or position 2. We understand, I guess we understand. So modem 1 has a internet card, modem 2 doesn't have internet card. Do you get me? So modem 1 has data, modem 2 doesn't have data. But now we are the same organization. Modem 1 is sitting on building 1, so modem 2 has to sit in building 2. So building 2, these guys, they cry that they don't get good signal from modem 1. So what do we do now? What we're gonna do now is we're gonna extend this to this. You get me? So, but this, we don't touch it. And also this, what we're gonna do, we're gonna give it a new username and password for the new guys. For the new guys in this building, they should use their own Wi-Fi name, Wi-Fi password. This one, they can use their Wi-Fi name, Wi-Fi password. Why? We're trying to say, is it working? Yes, it's working. But we don't want to do like when you do a repeater. Okay, it's a repeater anyway, somehow. But now we're going to give it a different name. That's what we're going to do. Second thing you have to know, these modems are from the same company. They use the same protocol, everything. So they have the same default gateway. But now what we have to do, we have to change this default gateway, because if two modems has one IP on the network, it's done, there's gonna be conflict on the network. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna change this, because I did change it already. It's working 100%. The Wi-Fi password is working, the Wi-Fi name is working on modem 2. So now you're gonna need a cable. You only put in this cable, you put run a cable from here to here. So the cable should not go in any port, but only these four, the yellow ones. You can put yellow to yellow here. So these ports, forget them. Any port, please forget that any port. Use the yellow port to be even 100% sure. Count from the middle ports. Use the 1, 2 and put in. So you run a cable from here to here. You understand? Once you connected this cable to here, then you're done. But now don't connect anything. Disconnect this line one, modem one, let it be disconnected. If you're using a laptop, disconnect all network, all networks, like maybe Wi-Fi stuff. Then what you do, connect a LAN cable here in one of the ports here, then put it on your laptop. Once you put it on your laptop, then you're gonna use what they call, I'm gonna log in because I gave it, we're only dealing with modem two. Why? Because modem 1 doesn't need any settings. So modem 2 is the one which is looking for some settings to be fine. So what you do, you go to your browser after connecting your modem 2 to the computer. So you go and say 192, because the old modem default gateway is gonna be 192.168.8.1. So if you're using a different modem, you can go to the back of the modem, or is this a number like this? Some of them, they start with 10.1.1.2, 10.0.0.1. But this one starts with starts with 192.168.8.1. But what I did, I changed it. I'm gonna show you how to change it. So there are two modems now on the network. Okay, let me show you. The first modem, when you go into that, your modem is gonna be like this. You're gonna put in 10 dot 192.168.8.1. So okay, when you're there, it's gonna give you settings, then you're gonna put in admin, then it's gonna give you admin, but I changed already, so it won't give you a chance to use admin. So once you're in, it said no admin, give me admin. Okay, it didn't work, it's fine. Admin, admin 2. Let me see. Yes, okay. The first modem I used admin 2, and the second modem I used admin 1. So you can see what's going on here. The first modem, this is modem 1, but now we told you to log into modem 2. Why? Because modem 2 has what they call it's using the same of this same default IP, but we're gonna change it. So we have logged into modem 1 to show you that. I hope you're not getting confused. We only set up modem 2, but we're logging into modem 1 to show you that they have different IP addresses, because that's where we did this, and also they have different Wi-Fi password and names. You get me? So you can see modem 1, it has different name for Wi-Fi, and also it has different name for what? For the IP. For IP. IP, you can see the IP address is this, because this is the default, we didn't change it. Okay, well, then we're gonna go to modem 2. We're done with modem 1. Modem 2, we're gonna sign out here. You should wanna log out. I'm logging out. You've seen, and it's on network, is the one which gives network. It's running on a 4G, it's connected. So now we're gonna go to modem 2, which we gave a password, a username, which is called, it's called what? It's called 100. So we gave it the default gateway to be 100. That's why you can see in modem 2, the SIM card is cancelled. When you say there, you go to home, when you click go home. So we already changed the password, use the username. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna use, okay, admin. In your case, we on modem 2, guys. Now this is the one we're gonna put in the next building. So we log into modem 2. So once you log in, don't worry about this IP. This IP, we changed it. So also you're gonna change it. Let's show you. This is the only thing you're gonna do. Then you're gonna fly. So what you do? Go to 1WLAN. Then after they click on click on DHCP. After that, on DHCP, then you can find this IP. This IP is gonna be 192.168.8.1, but then put 00 to make it 100.100. Then after that, what you're gonna do, look into the second line here, it says DHCP server enabled. So it's gonna be enabled, make it disabled. Once you do that, just say apply. Once you apply, everything is done. Now what you need to do only is to go and change your Wi-Fi set name and username. So if you don't change it, it's fine. Why? You're gonna use the one default one on your modem, on back of your modem. But now if you wanna change it, you can go to LAN basics. Let's see. Okay, here is what I do. So now you can put in the new username for your Wi-Fi, and also new password for your Wi-Fi. Then you say apply. Once you've applied, then everything is 100%, guys. Once you apply that tip, switch off your modem. The modem is gonna, after doing all those things, the modem is gonna do what? It's gonna reboot itself. Then it's gonna do what? It's gonna be ready for connection. So we set only the what? The second modem. One, in the second modem, we change the username. We change the what? We change the IP address to 100, because they are the same modems, so they have the same default gateway. So we have to change it. Another thing why we changed it is that we're telling, we did click what they call the HTPC. You saw the HTPC here. Here, you can read much about it. So once you turn it off, it simply means this modem is not going to give any device what they call supply the device with the IP. So it won't supply IP addresses. So Once you've done that, guys, this is very, very simple. Don't get complicated. The only thing you set up is here. You just click tip there. Then on the IP address, you put maybe 100 or 87, 57, whatever number, which you're going to remember is fine here. You put in the last column here. Then you apply tip. Once you apply, you're fine. You may set up your Wi-Fi password and username, or you might not set it up. So, but I prefer to set it up, because why? You're going to disconnect on your phone, disconnect every Wi-Fi password, then you connect to the new one. Once you connect to the new one, you will know that, oh, what I did, it worked. Then if you want to put it to the default one, whatever, then you can do that. But then this is for the testing, you have to do that. Then after you change your password, use a Wi-Fi password, Wi-Fi name and Wi-Fi password, then you say apply. Once you've applied, everything's fine. Now, what is next? Switch off the modem. After applying, it's gonna switch off itself anyway. So after applying, then I'm gonna show you here what you do. You're going to now run a cable, which is gonna run from from this modem to this modem, even when you're still in the same area. Then test your wireless Wi-Fi network. Then also, if you're using another computer, also you can give those computers something. But anyway, this is done because of much of people who are using wireless networks, you get me. So this is crazily good, guys. We managed to do access point using two Huawei wireless modems. That's a very cool thing to do, guys. If you have any questions or if you got confused, I'm sorry about that, but we ensure we did the right job. One, don't forget, don't change this, the router one. Don't change the IP. They only change the IP for router 2. Second option, second rule, turn off the DHCP. Save. Once you save, then you can change the username and password for Wi-Fi on this modem 2. Then rule 3, you have to connect a LAN cable from here to here. Thanks, guys. Don't forget to subscribe. And this is Azania Tutorials. Don't forget to ask any question if you didn't understand. I can give extra help on that. And also, please don't forget to share our content. And also, follow us on Facebook, on Twitter, whatever, guys, you feel like it's okay for us to do for us. You can share and also make our channel grow. But one of the best thing you have to do for us is subscribe on this channel. And also, click on that bell so that you get all the updates when we do a new video. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video.